Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel. Our topic of discussion is gene therapy. Gene therapy is nothing but a replacement of a defective gene by transferring good genes into the humans to treat the genetic disorders. The genetic makeup of the patient cell is manipulated to get the new genes by using recombinant DNA technology. So it was first successfully implemented in 1990. Let us see the types of gene therapy based on the delivery methods, how the gene is delivered. So there are two methods, one is ex vivo gene therapy and one is in vivo gene therapy. In the ex vivo method, the genes are introduced into the isolated cells. The genetic makeup is modified, then they are reinfused into the target tissues. Example, bone marrow cells are utilized for this. In vivo gene therapy, the genes are directly introduced into the target tissues. The genes travel in the blood and reach the target tissues. So it is mainly used to deliver the genes to non-dividing cells such as brain. The types of gene therapy based on the type of the target cells. There are two types. One is somatic cell line gene therapy or germ line cell gene therapy. In somatic cell line gene therapy, only the somatic cells are used. They doesn't pass to the manipulation of the gene does not have an impact on the offsprings. So this form of gene therapy is only permitted only ethically till now. In germline gene therapy, the genes are introduced into the sperms or ova. They pass on to the next generation or the future generations. This type of germline gene therapy is not ethically approved till now because of the ethical issues. How the genes are transferred from taken from one cell and how they are transferred to another cell, they use some carriers called viral vectors. The viruses, different viral vectors used are retrovirus, adenovirus, adeno associated virus, lentivirus, and herpes simplex virus. So these viruses are made incompetent to multiply and they are good carriers of genes. They can easily transfer the genetic material because they are just RNA or DNA viruses. They have different viruses have different properties. Some are suitable for dividing cells and some are suitable for non-dividing cells. And some viruses, they can accommodate more genes and some are suitable, they doesn't cause immune reactions, but some are immunogenic. So every virus has its advantages and disadvantages. The herpes system, herpes simplex virus used for nervous system, and the lentivirus is can accommodate a large KB of genes. The retroviral genome used as a vector for gene therapy. Let us see how this happens. Let us take a retrovirus RNA genome containing the gene of interest. So that is added with the target cells by endocytosis. The retrovirus enters into the cells and their viral uncoating happens with the help of the reverse transcriptase. The viral RNA is reverse transcribed to DNA and the DNA is attaching to the host DNA. That is the recombination of the DNA happens or manipulation of the DNA, host DNA happens, and the good gene is thus incorporated into the target cells. So let us see this in brief. The viral genome, that is a retroviral genome, has a different regions, the initiation region with 5' long terminal repeats or packaging signal regions, 3' terminal regions of transcription, and the genes required for replication and packaging, that is GAG, POL and ENV. So this is the retroviral genome. The GAG, POL and ENV region is usually deleted and used for addition or ligating of the target genes. So let us take the target gene or the gene of interest. So it is the GAG, POL and ENV region is deleted and the new gene is ligated in this area. So the replication does not happen because the replication genes are deleted, it becomes incompetent. So the viral genome gets edited by removal of GAG, POL and ENV and ligated with the gene of interest. So there are non-viral strategies also for gene transfer. Since the viral strategies have the problems of immunogenic response, mutagenesis and adverse effects, the non-viral strategies have evolved. So one is uncomplexed DNA, DNA coated gold particles, liposomal gene delivery and DNA protein complex. Let us see these things in brief. This is the uncomplexed DNA for gene therapy. So the DNA with the good gene is directly injected into the target tissues. So it is also called naked DNA. Example, the gene for synthesis of erythropoietin is injected directly for the patients who have chronic renal failure associated anemia. It is very simple, does not require any special equipment. Limitations, they express only for a short term and they don't work in all the tissues. The next is DNA coated gold particles for gene therapy. The small DNA coated gold particles are with the help of a gene gun and a pressure treatment or electrical treatment delivers the gene into the target tissues such as skin. It penetrates into the skin. So it is suitable for delivery of gene into superficial tissues. The same limitations it also has, short term gene expression and low efficiency. The next is a liposomal gene delivery for gene therapy. The liposomes with the target genes are taken and it is attached with the target cells. They are taken by endocytosis into the target cells. Degradation of the liposome in the cytoplasm delivers the good gene that enters into the nucleus. So there, by recombination with the DNA, the gene of interest is attached into the host chromosome of the target cell. So two types of liposomes are available for gene delivery. One is anionic and one is cationic. The next is a DNA protein complex for gene therapy. Here the DNA with the good gene is taken and the protein linkers are used here, antigen antibody conjugates, biotin, streptavidin or poly L lysine. The DNA with the good gene is attaches to the receptor or the target cells via the linker, and this delivers the gene, the good gene, into the target cells. The first successful gene therapy is used for adenosine deaminase deficiency in the year 1990. So here example is given, the host with a defective ADA gene, that is adenosine deaminase gene. So individuals deficient in ADA, they have increased concentration of deoxyadenosine. Beyond a certain limit, it is toxic to the lymphocytes, which results in severe combined immunodeficiency disease. So in this technique, the T cells are removed from the patient. It is cultured and with the help of the retrovirus, the good genes are incorporated into the T cells, and now the cell contains the genome of the cell contains both the normal and the defective gene. So the normal ADA gene is incorporated into the viral, into the genome by the help of the virus. So it is transfected into the lymphocytes and genetically modified such that it contains a normal ADA gene. So now the cells are infused. The gene corrected lymphocytes are infused back into the SCAD patient. So this was the first successfully applied gene therapy in the year 1990. It's a short nutshell information of the gene therapy. I hope it will be useful for you. If you like this video, kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel. If you like this video, kindly press the like button, share to many of your friends. Thank you. Happy learning.